Good evening, everyone. My name is Rob Natter. I'm the director of choral music here, and I'd like to welcome you all to our spring concert. Thank you so much for being here tonight. Really appreciate it. The concert features audiamas, of course, and concert choir and college choir, and we have lots of music to sing for you tonight. One little bit of business, if you could all make sure that your cell phones won't make noise during the concert, we would sure appreciate that. And going on, you'll hear quite a variety of music from audiamas this evening. You just heard Voices of the Ancients, which was meant to evoke a kind of timeless atmosphere. Our next song is also timeless, a setting of a text from the Latin Mass. Agnus Dei means Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. And this text, when it's set to music, is usually stated three times, the last time ending in Grant us peace, Dona Nobis Pacem. In this setting, listen how each statement of the Agnus Dei gets progressively more complex, even more ecstatic, before quieting, before the final prayer for Grant us peace. This is Agnus Dei.
Their male counterparts earned. The situation is much worse for women of color. color, with some groups paid as little as 57% as the men. And women still carry a disproportionate burden in areas like child and community care. Tonight, we offer this song about women, past and present, stepping boldly into the firelight.
We are the descendants. Computer Science and Music double major in Gettysburg College, and I will be introducing the piece, Yeniden, composed by Hasan Uçarsu, who happens to be a Turkish composer, which is where I'm from. The piece translates to anew or again, which emphasizes that no matter what, how we go through the distractions and our lives tumble as if falling from a falling waterfall, the sun will rise again and shine and shimmer on the water anew. I hope you enjoy this hopeful tune and join us in going through every struggle.
Sürgün üstümüze, sürgün üstümüze, çöken karanlıkta, çöken karanlıkta. Sürgün üstümüze, sürgün üstümüze, çöken karanlıkta.
my name is Carolina, and I am a senior. Senior music and Latin American Caribbean Latino studies double major, and I've been part of the Gettysburg College Choir for 2 years now, which is a lifetime. So the next two pieces we will be singing in sort of a cycle. The first piece is Moonset, and while we're singing this piece, I want you all to think of being in the woods in the Pacific Northwest, sort of the full moon shining, creating some sort of light and that eeriness. And then for a second piece, Mata del Anima Sola, we go down south to Venezuela, to the plains of Venezuela, and picture yourself as a cowboy, a cowgirl, whatever you identify with, and just picture yourself riding through these great fields in sort of the sunset. So I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
hardest things to do at a concert is to move people around. So thank you for your patience with that. It has been our tradition at the last major concert of the year to recognize the seniors of the choirs. So I'm going to read their names in alphabetical order. And so choir, when I say your name, please raise your hand proudly so that your adoring audience can find you. Right? Please withhold the pause until I've read all of the names. Zachary Besh, College Choir and Camerata. Olivia Duffy, College Choir and Camerata. Mallory Duggan, College Choir, Audiamus Concert Choir. Bridget Dunleavy, Audiamus and Concert Choir. Raise your hand higher, Bridget. There you are. Hannah Evans, Audiamus and Concert Choir. Julia Gokal, College Choir, Audiamus Concert Choir. Hannah Molina, College Choir, Concert Choir. Casey Ottaway, College Choir and Camerata. Blaise Veris, there he is. Concert Choir, Audrey White, Concert Choir. We are sad to see you go, but we are very excited to see what you'll do next. And most of all, we're so proud and grateful for your musicality and your commitment and dedication to singing in choirs over the years. Please give the seniors a warm round of applause. So that means there will be a bit of movement in the middle, but we'll try to keep the musical moment alive and intact. So please hold applause until the end of the whole piece. Michael John Trotta is an up-and-coming composer of new music for choirs from university level to church and educational choirs. He was commissioned to write For a Breath of Ecstasy for the 2018 commemoration of the 100th anniversary of the poet Sarah Teasdale receiving the first Pulitzer Prize in poetry. This is a remarkable achievement for anyone, much less a woman poet in that era. The composer writes about his piece that each movement of the piece chronicles Teasdale's search for solace amidst life's many storms. The tapestry of voices with oboe and strings reveals moments of yearning, love, joy, and peace. Vivid imagery portrays transcendent moments of solace that are revealed in an individual's relationship to nature and to love. The texts are all printed in your program, and we invite you to read as well as listen to these beautiful poems, and we hope you enjoy For a Breath of Ecstasy.
Thank you. Thank you.